can swim anywhere. He can breathe underwater and go flying through the air.
The double submariner trips on their feet, losing weight as he sails.
The sailor of Atlantis is the prince of the sea.
Disclaimer, I do not. The following video is my very own opinion, and I do not insult. I'm not going to insult Screw Attack because of one reason. Because the following is my very own opinion, and also, if you guys disagree with me, that's fine. That's your opinion. But this is my very own opinion, and I'm now going to explain this right now. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Hey guys, Jose and Shiba here. Now today we're gonna debunk Aquaman versus Namor. So I decided, you know what, we're gonna have this thing since I'm done with school. I just graduated on Friday. That's why you saw no new video, because I graduated. And now, after that, now here's something I'm gonna say to them. Well, alright, so now let's explain this. So I'm about to spoil Aquaman versus Namor. Okay, here goes. 3, 2, 1, there's spoiler alert, Aquaman won. And oh, this is the part where I disagree. Now I'm explaining why Namor should have won. I'm tired, my Namor wins. So, let me tell you, okay. So there are some versions of Aquaman, like New 52, Rebirth. Why, those versions, they get slapped in the face by classic Namor. Well, and then there are some versions of Aquaman that would just destroy Namor without effort. So, without further ado, we're gonna go up to this, to them right now. Let's go. So, we're only gonna focus on the post-analysis because they got everything else right, but the post-analysis, let's analyze, we're gonna debunk that post-analysis. So, without further ado, let's get started to analyzing right now.
Sweating so much from how intense that got.
Aquaman and Namor's powers were so similar and well matched, this fight could have reasonably gone in either one's favor. In fact, neither had many powers that the other did not possess in some way.
Like how Namor had his mutant wing feet, but Aquaman's magic trident could let him fly too.
Still, while Namor could certainly have won this in some circumstances, Aquaman had the potential he needed to take the victory more times than not.
Namor could match Savage Hulk, who held up 150 billion tons. But remember, Aquaman stopped Atlan's continent-crushing attack, which had a potential energy over 150 trillion tons of TNT.
Not exactly a one-to-one comparison, but consider Namor's own similar feat, keeping the island Utopia from falling. We can estimate the island's size and weight using this panel, coming to a little over 178,000 tons. Considering the weight applied as force through the pillar Namor was pushing up, this means the potential energy exerted onto Namor would only be 1,425 tons of TNT. The energy Aquaman stopped was 109 billion times greater.
Okay, but here's something I'm gonna say, bring up that part. But here's the thing. Lifting strength and striking strength are two completely different things because of one reason. Lifting strength means you're strong enough to lift something, but striking strength means you're strong enough to hit something that hard. But Aquaman takes lifting strength, but Namor, he takes striking strength. Let me show you why. For example, I'm showing you lifting strength versus striking strength. For example, I'll tell you. Every time he's fought the Hulk, he's beaten the Hulk, like, on more than one occasion. I'm not even lying. More than one occasion, he has fought the Hulk because, well, because he's done that so many times. Every time he's fought him, he's always been able to beat him. That's not good striking strength, but here's another one. Here he is. He takes better striking strength. He one time made punch so hard to make Sentry bleed. And that's not crazy enough. He was able, strong enough, to knock Wolverine out with just a straight punch. That's powerful of Namor. Powerful Namor is. And then there's more striking strength I can bring up for feats for Namor. Let me show you. Now here he is. He literally made a Kree member bleed with just a single punch. Heck, even this happened.
Heck, even Captain America admits that they can be basically go on par with Ronin. Because they're literally Kree, they can literally fight Ronin. Come on. They can literally fight him. Okay, there's more striking strength. He takes flight and he kicks Hercules in the head and may have offering him to bleed. And Hercules has done 1 feat better than since he is the god of strength. And he can literally tap the other people. And Hercules was fast enough to even, the god of strength Hercules was fast enough to tag Quicksilver. And Hercules was strong enough to even lift up, get this, he lifted up Godzilla. And Godzilla was estimated to weigh about 1.7 kilotons. And that is still heavier than Aquaman lifting that trident. You know, Godzilla, King of the Monsters, Gojira, this guy. And there's another striking feat. Okay, now striking strength, I'll show you this right now. This sounds crazy, but it's actually true. Here he is. He punched Thanos so hard, he made Thanos even bleed with a single punch. See, this is how you make Thanos bleed, Tony Stark. He did not just punch Thanos, he even survived. They don't talk about durability. He even survived Thanos giving him a beatdown so hard, he literally broke his bones. Thanos literally broke Namor's bones. Oh, sorry about that. But here he is. You even mentioned that he can even go up against Thor from Trident to Hammer. Literally, Mjolnir to his trident. His trident's a lot stronger than Aquaman's because he can literally match Thor. And speaking of Thor's striking strength, I'm gonna say it since you're gonna scale him to that. You say this about Thor in Ultron. Yeah, you say this about Thor cracking planets in Ultron vs. Sigma. Here, let me show you this clip.
When Thor fought Gore the God Butcher, their battle created shockwaves powerful enough to shatter planets thousands of miles away. This could only be possible with a force equivalent to 682 septillion tons of TNT.
Namor blocking Mjolnir is a lot stronger, so that proving my point that Namor's trident can also fight Aquaman's. And it's stronger because it's been able to go against Mjolnir. So, next up, okay, let's do one more striking trait, okay? Okay, no more striking strength, but we'll go on to durability next. Now, remember how I said durability like that? Now, here's another durability feat I found. Now, there is another durability feat. Okay, so right here. So, I think the Avengers, yeah, I think Iron Man, Black Panther, I want to call her Captain Marvel, but I'm calling her Miss Marvel for right now, because if I say Captain Marvel, everyone's going to think it's Shazam. But, anyways, here she is. She punched... Anyway, so he's fighting Iron Man. So here's what happens. She literally punches Namor so hard, they literally send a shockwave throughout the ocean. But speaking of the ocean. Remember how that ocean that basically hurted her, hitted them? Here's how to scale the ocean. Remember that ocean feat I remember? Do you know this ocean feat I brought up? So the ocean feat. Literally, when she punched him through, let's scale that ocean. So that would take about 681 sextillion pounds. And that is a force enough to destroy our moon. So yeah, that would prove my point for Namor's durability. He's still more durable. Now let's get on to the most thing, speed. Alright guys, now next... Next we're gonna focus on the next category after durability. Speed. So without further ado, let's get on to speed. Oh boy, they messed it up. Let me show you the speed for what they say about both of them.
Sure, Namor was fast enough to easily catch up to the Human Torch, who flies over 140 miles per hour on a normal day, and sometimes even thousands of times the speed of sound.
But Aquaman has routinely kept pace with Wonder Woman, who has been frequently shown to move thousands of times the speed of light.
How can you up the speed, Death Battle? Okay, now next they messed up the speed. How is the speed messed up? Well, let me tell you why. The speed is messed up because of one reason. I see Death Battle is messing up the speed. So here's the thing. They scaled Namor to a Human Torch, but now they don't... After they scaled Namor to a Human Torch, they scaled Aquaman to Wonder Woman, who moves light speed. This is clearly false, but I'm going to show you why. No, well, here's the thing. Namor is still faster, because Namor was fast enough to catch up to characters like Sentry, Iron Man, and even fight Black Bolt, and here's another faster than light reaction feat. Heck, I forgot to mention, he even tagged Wizard just by himself, and he thought Wizard was Quicksilver. And he has better reaction feet because... Here, let me show you something. I'll show you some comic panels right now. Heck, he was fast enough to catch Captain America's shield and even throw it right back at him. And it made him hit his head. It's not the only speed feat I found. Well, he has better reactive speed because he can react to characters like Sunfire, Golden Girl, and he can even travel speed. He can catch up to characters like Iron Man, Doctor Strange, and Black Bolt and light years in space. That's proof. That is still fat proof that he could catch up to those characters in space.
Yeah, but none of that strength and speed would matter if the Submariner just ordered a bunch of sharks to eat him first, right?
Namor could command sea life, sure, but Aquaman could directly dominate their minds and force them to act on his will. And while Namor can telepathically communicate with other Atlanteans, he could not create hemorrhages or seizures like Aquaman could. Though Namor could certainly resist these mental attacks, similar to how he survived the Purple Man, this is still solid evidence that Aquaman's telepathy was more powerful.
Oh, and don't forget, Aqua King can make his underwater buddies physically stronger with the clear, while Namor was stuck commanding plain old everyday fish.
Okay, so my next point they bring up is, they bring up this. Okay. So now it's a lot better. Sorry if it sounded a little clear, but now it's a bit more clear. Now, okay, here we go. So now they say that because of Aquaman's powers, he can possess someone. But here's something I want to prove. That, yes, that is true. He can basically collect other people. But do you know which version of Aquaman you're using? Because it depends on which Aquaman it does. You didn't... For example, why Cartoon Fight Club did it? Because there are some versions of Aquaman that have different powers that the main Aquaman does not have. But what you said about him and Namor controlling a regular fish? Well, you say this about Namor consuming these creatures. These fish.
Animate objects and his surroundings to create living beings to fight alongside him. And that's not even the only magic doohickey Namor has. He can use the Giganto, which is a super whale, with arms. Look out, birds with arms. I'm starting a new subreddit.
Sorry about that. Oops, wrong clip. Sorry about that, guys.
Giganto is strong enough to withstand the blast of an atomic bomb. Still pales in comparison to Namor's own strength.
Not just that. You just... The whale, in which you don't use the fight because it costs so much animation. You even say this about him summoning these creatures.
Far more impressively, he can telepathically communicate with all types of marine life, including other Atlanteans, and can persuade them to follow his commands. Whether it be a squadron of armored sharks or a giant killer whale, the creatures of the sea follow the first mutant's lead.
Yes, the armored sharks will most likely be a perfect counter. Okay, we're going to talk about first, we're not going to talk about the mine, we're going to talk about the fish he can summon. Yeah, but however, he can summon orcas. A giant killer whale, which is orcas. Now, orcas literally just live in the Arctic, in the ocean. However, here's something I want to say. But I know you guys are gonna say, but Joe's 2099, they're dangerous. They're not that dangerous to the system. It's that the people, you the people, basically hurt these poor creatures. Orcas. I'm looking right at you, SeaWorld. For hurting these poor creatures. I know you'll not be, maybe be like, Joe's 2099, that's crazy. Well, guess what? These orcas can literally take out sharks. I'm not even lying. According to abcnews.com, they literally say, and according to some scientists, orcas literally have the better bite force than sharks. But, however, they can literally fight sharks. Literally. They're literally the velociraptors of the sea world. You know the velociraptors in dinosaurs? Jurassic Park. Jurassic World. Oh god, I'm kneeling. Anyways, back on topic. Let me show you some footage of orcas basically attacking the shark.
The killer whale and the great white turn on each other. These ancient enemies sometimes go after the same prey, hunting sea lions head to head.
They literally...
With blood in the water, this shark is bold. But then the whale strikes its competition.
They're striking animals. How fast they can move when they actually... make the determination to attack their prey is remarkable.
The shark is stunned, then held upside down till he suffocates. The victors feast. In the end, this collision of killers is no contest. With its massive strength and adaptive intelligence, the orca has no equal at sea.
According to that, that would prove that Namor can literally summon a killer whale, or orca, an orca, to literally feast on Aquaman sharks. Because orcas can literally take out sharks. Literally. Every time an orca fights a great white, the orca manages to actually fight the great white just by themselves. Or sometimes they go in duos and just attack it. That's because orcas literally focus on... use their head and instead of using being... because they have better intelligence than the shark. So, by that logic, now let's get on to the part where they said he can possess him, or mind control. But here's the thing. Let me show you something. Okay, so while finding it here, I'm just going to show this picture of this Moby Dick, Moby Dick whale, in which that was the name of the whale Namor can summon. Literally, yes. And he can literally... as they said, they can survive a nuclear bomb. But now, I will give you the true presentation of what they said. Now to the mind control. So, when he got possessed by Doctor Strange went inside him, he broke off the ribbons of... wait, let me go look up the name real quickly. Yeah, there we go. The Crimson Brands. He broke off the Crimson Brands by himself with the strength. Now, that is pretty good strength, because literally you would need to be someone like Hulk or Thanos to rip through them. This is comic Thanos, not comic... like, not comic... movie Thanos in Infinity War. Usually you already know what happens. So yeah, him surviving Doctor Strange possessed going inside his mind can prove he could still survive anything that Aquaman can throw at him. So yeah, in conclusion, this means Aquaman takes lifting strength, and he takes powers, while Namor, he takes arsenal, and he takes speed and striking strength. And he does have better feats than Aquaman does. So yeah, that's how I would do it for today. Let me know in the comments. Do you agree with me or do you disagree with me? All you want. But this is my own opinion. So without further ado, come back next week where IT Punk, Spider-Man 2099 versus, Spider-Man 2099 versus Batman Beyond, because my next reaction is going to be Johnny Cage versus Captain Falcon, but that's what I have to say. And also next month, Spider-Man month. So, Johnny Cage, no, not Johnny Cage versus,
Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna react to Johnny Cage versus Captain Falcon. Johnny Cage for Mortal Kombat versus Captain Falcon will be probably be my next video. So, come back next week, and I will probably debunk Batman Beyond for Spider-Man 29 because I got the next movie. So, that's it. So, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, share this video with others. I'll see you guys next time. Later. And this is really fishy. And I see Death Battle about to be debunked. Mateys. Okay, bye.
Stands on golden stairs and watches the ships that go sailing somewhere behind the sea. She's there watching me. If I could fly like birds on high, then straight to her arms I'll go see. Stars, it's near beyond the moon. I know beyond a doubt my heart will lead me there soon. We'll meet beyond the shore. We'll kiss just like before. Happy we'll be beyond the sea.